Hey guys, welcome back to the vlog. It is officially the first week of college, which is so exciting. Doesn't really feel like it though, because for the first 3 weeks, everything is apparently online. We are in level 3 in Dublin, which honestly, I don't really know what that means, but my classes this week are gonna be online. It is Monday though, so I don't have any class today. I think I'm gonna try and get some readings done in the afternoon, but I'm gonna go meet my friend for brunch and coffee. It was her birthday a few weeks ago, so I'm gonna have like a little catch up, and that's basically just gonna be my morning. I went for a run today for like the first time in forever, which was really good. It's kind of weird running around Dublin because I don't know, it's like all like streets and stuff, and it was raining, but now the sun's actually starting to come out, which is quite nice.
I look like I'm genuinely going back to school, to like some prep school or something, but I'm just wearing this polo shirt thing. It's from Depop. It's originally from Brandy Melville. And this jumper I got in a charity shop. My Levi's I also got off Depop. And oh, I also got my glasses from Ace and Tate the other day, which I'll leave the style on the screen. They're really simple. They're just like these gold wire frames. I have really bad vision. I'm like -2.5. And yeah, I think they make me look extra studious. Happy first day back at college. We're off to the library. Gonna go get
new
some
normal.
Gonna go get some work done if we're allowed in. Let's see. Good to be back on campus, and it's like the sun came out, which is lovely, but it is so quiet today. We went to the library and like you can only sit like 10 people at a time, which is kind of bizarre, but got some reading done. Pasta! Oh my god!
Best takeaway pasta in Dublin.
The infamous
4 euro.
The infamous Cartlicchio's.
They wow. Have a lovely pesto one week.
Yeah.
For future reference.
Oh. Two very happy girls. Cartlicchio's biggest fans.
Oh my god, my year is just.
Hey guys, so I just got back from college. I did a little library session, which was really nice. It was so good to be back in the library, but there was literally like 10 seats available in the first floor. I know that's for COVID and stuff, but it just feels really bizarre. But it was good to get back, and I do just want to get in like a nice routine of leaving the apartment and going to the library or somewhere to study, because I only have 4 hours of class a week, and at the minute it's all on Wednesday. So I don't know where my 3 grand is going, but I'm paying for 4 hours of college a week. I was meant to have 2 art history seminars, which are both in person. Because Dublin is in level 3, I don't know what level 3 like actually means, but it's some level of COVID being bad. And basically uni is all online for the first 3 weeks. I don't know how long that's gonna go on for. I doubt it will go back to normal after 3 weeks. But yeah, I am a bit bummed, but at the same time, I'm trying to be hopeful and I'm really excited to do my modules. My first module is 19th century British and Irish painting. I've never studied Irish painting before. I've done a little bit of British stuff, but I'm kind of excited. I don't know. It sounds like a little dry, but the lecture is really good. That's kind of why I picked it. He's one of my favorite lecturers at Trinity. I'm trying to get him to be my dissertation supervisor as well because I feel like we get along really well. And for the second module, I actually just recently switched. I was signed up to do a contemporary art painting thing, but I reread the description and it just like didn't seem to be that interesting anymore. It was mainly like science and technology focused, which just isn't really a bit of me. So I'm switching to a Renaissance architecture module. You guys know that I love studying Renaissance architecture. I didn't really know the professor who was taking it, but I did some research on her and she was actually teaching at Columbia University for like 5 years before this. So I feel like she's gonna be really good. And I really like having a mixture of like architecture and painting, fine art. So I'm excited to take both of those. And I'm also excited to figure out my dissertation a bit more. But yeah, I feel like my uni weeks are gonna be very chill. It's just gonna be a lot of independent research and reading. Let me know what you guys are doing for like school and uni and college down below, if we're in a similar boat or whatever. I think we just gotta stay positive and try to enjoy this time. Good morning guys, I am en route to Abby's house because we are going on a hike this morning. It is such a beautiful day. It's kind of chilly, but it's really sunny. So me and Meg and Abby, we're gonna drive somewhere. We're not allowed to leave Dublin, but I think we have a few ideas where we could potentially go. So it's actually really early, I'm really tired, but I'm excited.
What a cute view!
This is so nice. I'm shocked.
Dublin's great.
Wholesome activities for today.
What's this called?
No, not that one. Don't want to do that.
I think we'll be fine.
You would say that.
Yeah, you have not.
Me and I think all we have to do is follow the path.
Curve Arch Trail, 5K, 1 hour.
Moderate difficulty.
All right.
Loop Trail. So where is the map of it?
Where is the loop?
Okay, what does it say?
Is there a color?
There's dots, but they don't.
Oh, but there's only one. Yeah, look, there's only one. Well, I'm sad that no one loved. Sad that no one loved. Can you call this a hike?
To let you know, at the end.
It's a walk. Seems like we're living in a class. Well, I've got nobody heard. Nobody found me. Oh, our city's so beautiful, guys.
I think as far as we can see,
all of us not from Dublin. We're in Tesco.
Hey,
hey Meg.
Oh, that's right by the entrance.
Brilliant. This is Abby's mask. It's washed though.
I did wash it.
It's okay, wash it.
Don't out yourself.
I did wash it.
I got rainbows.
It was in my underwear drawer, my clean underwear drawer sitting there.
You look so gangster in the black one.
Does it fit? I'm from London.
Look at us getting all our vegetables.
Good health queens.
Vegan haul.
Exactly.
It's vegetables.
It's just vegetables. I want a sweet potato.
There on the end.
Okay, sick. We did a big shop today. Lots of food.
Just got back from Tesco. Abby was so nice and she drove us to like one of the big Tescos. I feel like the vegetables there are cheaper than like the Dunn's beside me. So just got like mushrooms, broccoli, carrots, spinach. Treated myself to a mango. I love mango. Got some bananas as well. A pepper, bread, coffee, chocolate. Got some of the Alpro yogurt. This one's pretty nice. It's okay. Green lentils, love the canned lentils, reduced fat hummus, and a few tins of black beans. So this should do me for like, I don't know, a few days, a week, maybe. These stuff I can like keep. Also, look at all this shit I need to clean. I need to clean this. I need to take out the bins. We need to clean this. I mean, it's not really mine, but I hate being in a messy kitchen.
I'm so hungry. It's 2:45 and I haven't eaten anything today. Oh my god, that's so bad. I'm very hungry. I'm probably just gonna make some porridge. Got some bananas. Might do like a blueberry banana porridge.
Very wintry this morning.
Good morning. Happy Wednesday. It's officially my first day of class. So I'm just trying to log into my Zoom meeting. My Wi-Fi is being super slow though in here, so that's not a good sign. Got my coffee. It's 10 a.m. Not too early. I think this is just going to be like an introductory class, so nothing too taxing. And yeah, actually I have a really nice day planned today. I'm going to my friend's house to do some painting later, which I'm very excited about because I haven't painted in like 2 months, ever since I finished that portrait of my mom. So yeah, we're just gonna have like tea, chats, do some painting. In the evening I'm gonna catch up on some college work.
I just finished up my first lecture, which was so exciting. It was really interesting. I did have some technical issues though, because the Wi-Fi doesn't properly stretch into my room. So I had to go into the living room and Kath and Cass were doing their English class at the same time. And we were just all on Zoom. And I mean, kind of like a weird vibe for like university, but I guess that's how it's gonna be for the rest of the semester. Just good to be back in some capacity. But anyway, I've actually just been opening some parcels because some lovely people have been sending me some really nice things. So I might just do like a little unboxing.
First up, we have the cutest ceramics from my girl Lola. She's one of my really good friends off like Instagram and YouTube. I met her in London and she's currently based in Australia right now. And look at these gingham pieces. Oh my god, I think they're adorable. I can't wait to put them on my desk or maybe like in the living room as well. So thank you so much, girl. Next up, I got the most beautiful dress from Before July. They are a UK-based company. Annalisa, she's so sweet. She also hand makes everything, which is just amazing. So it's like slow fashion, sustainably made from deadstock fabrics. And I'm so excited about this dress. Like, look at this color. Okay, give me a sec. Guys, look at this dress. It is so beautiful. I love the color. It's so well made. And the sleeves, oh my gosh, I cannot wait to wear this. And she also sent me one of her new tote bags, which are just so cute. It's gonna be perfect for doing like grocery shopping and stuff. I also received a package from Woven, which I'm so excited about because they do sustainable activewear. It says that each piece is made from 15 to 30 recycled bottles. And I really need new like workout clothes, so I'm really excited to try these out. They sent me some leggings and biker shorts and workout tops, so thank you guys so, so much. That is so sweet, and I obviously love that it's all sustainable. And the last thing I want to share with you guys is this t-shirt. This girl reached out to me. She makes these t-shirts, and I think 50% of the profits go to Black communities and COVID relief funds, which is really cool. I'll leave her Instagram down below. Obviously, the shirt is really cute, and I love the message. But yeah, thank you guys so much for sending me things. I feel very, very grateful. Guys, I'm actually obsessed with this dress. How freaking cute is she? Oh my gosh. It also fits me perfectly. I think it's in a size XS. But thank you so much to Lisa for sending it to me. Feeling very grateful, and I hope that the sun will come out later this week so I can take her to the park or something. But it's just so gorgeous. I made some hummus sandwich things for lunch. It's just toast and hummus and spinach, peppers, tomatoes, and a little bit of pesto on top. So I'm just gonna eat that and finish up this reading that I started. It's kind of just like dissertation research, but it's really interesting. It's about the classical body, particularly the Greek body in later 19th century French painting.